Welcome back. My name's Tom, and today I'm taking a look at a live mall. This is Danbury Fair Mall in Danbury, Connecticut. This mall was built in 1986, and it's currently Connecticut's second largest mall, falling just behind Connecticut Post Mall, which is roughly 40,000 square feet larger. This video was filmed on a Thursday afternoon, about a week and a half before Christmas, so the amount of people in the mall might be a little bit more than it normally is just because of holiday shopping. But I would say overall, the mall appears to be doing fairly well. I wouldn't say it was extremely crowded, but it definitely wasn't empty, that's for sure. Now, to all of you that have been here before, especially back in the 80s or 90s, let me know how the crowds compare to back then. Does this look crowded to you, or does it look like a dead mall? Let me know in the comments. And don't forget, if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, leave a comment if you'd like, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. I do plan to have a few more mall videos coming up in the next few weeks and months, and I also do have a lot more flea market videos coming up as well. Thanks. When the mall first opened in 1986, there were only two anchor stores. There were Sears and G. Fox. This Macy's didn't open until a year later in 1987. As far as I can tell, this is the original location of the Macy's, but if I'm wrong, let me know. Again, I've never been here before, so I'm pulling all my information off the internet, and I think everybody knows how inaccurate the internet can be sometimes. This mall probably has the most impressive skylights I've seen of any of the malls in Connecticut, or at least it has far more skylights than most of the other malls I've been to so far. Based on my research, I think this used to be the Lord & Taylor here straight ahead. Lord & Taylor moved in 1991, and it didn't close until 2020. The reason I think this was the Lord & Taylor is based on the stairway in front of it, which I did see in some old photos. So again, if I'm wrong, if this was not Lord & Taylor, please let me know.
On the other side of the mall.
And fun fact, Danbury Fair Mall gets its name because it was actually built on the location of the old Danbury Fairgrounds. Believe it or not. And here's Santa. He's looking a little bit lonely. I don't know. I remember when I was a kid, there used to be a lot more kids lined up to sit with Santa. But maybe that's because of the time of the day, you know, being a Thursday afternoon. Maybe the kids are all in school. Not sure. But yeah, this year I've seen a lot of lonely Santas. And here's the food court. It's probably one of the more impressive food courts I've seen before. A lot of vendors here, a lot of good restaurants that I would be interested in personally. And the best part about it is, as you'll see straight ahead, is this amazing two-story carousel. Here's the JCPenney, which opened up in 1988. And I believe this is a side entrance. There's a larger entrance around the other side of the building. And if you stick around a little bit longer, we'll take a ride in that elevator. And then this is obviously the main entrance to JCPenney I was talking about. Straight ahead is Primark. Primark opened in 2015. Apparently it was one of the first Primarks in all of the United States. It actually is in the site of the old Sears. Sears was on this level as well as the ground level. And Sears actually stayed on the first floor up until 2020 when it closed for business. No Christmas shopping experience would be complete without a pop-up calendar store. Based on my research, this originally was the G. Fox building, or at least this is where the G. Fox building was. G. Fox became Filene's in 1993. Filene's closed in 2006. And then apparently this area here was constructed around 2010. So while I don't think that's the same building that G. Fox and Filene's was in, I think that's the same area that it was in. And again, if I'm wrong, let me know. Another thing that makes me think that this mall is doing pretty well is that all the escalators seem to work, which is a rarity nowadays. Straight ahead here, where Santa is now, used to be an enormous water fountain. From what I can tell, it was removed back around 2007-2008 when they did a full remodeling of this mall. And I think that's a shame. I love water fountains. I just think they add a lot to a mall. And other than the Stamford Town Center in Stamford, I don't think any malls in Connecticut actually still have water fountains. Here's the first floor of the old Sears, which moved out in 2020. And as you can see, nothing has moved in since then.
the other side of the mall.
Now let's take a ride on the elevator. It's nowhere near as impressive as the elevator at Stanford Town Center, which was, I don't know, probably 100 feet tall. This one's only two stories, but, you know, it's better than nothing, I guess. All right, well, that's pretty much everything inside the mall. But don't leave yet. I'm going to take a drive around the mall and we can see what it looks like from the outside.
Thank you.
This is the old second floor of the Sears building, which is currently occupied by Primark, but I'm guessing Primark doesn't use that entrance. I'm guessing, again, just a guess, I think probably Sears would have been the last ones to use that side of the building there. There you have it. That's the Danbury Fair Mall in Danbury, Connecticut. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Leave a comment if you'd like. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I do plan to have a few more mall videos coming up in the near future, as well as a ton of flea market videos and who knows what else type of videos. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.